They proceeded on their journey in a friendly group, for Polychrome had discovered that the Copper Man was harmless and was no longer afraid of him. Button Bright was also reassured and took quite a fancy to Tik-Tok. He wanted the Clockwork Man to open himself so that he might see the wheels go round, but that was a thing Tik-Tok could not do. Button Bright then wanted to wind up the Copper Man, and Dorothy promised he should do so as soon as any part of the machinery ran down. This pleased Button Bright, who held fast to one of Tik-Tok's copper hands as he trudged along the road, while Dorothy walked on the other side of her old friend, and Billina perched by turns upon his shoulder or his copper hat. Polly once more joyously danced ahead, and Toto ran after her, barking with glee. The Shaggy Man was left to walk behind, but he didn't seem to mind a bit, and whistled merrily and looked curiously upon the pretty scenes they passed. At last they came to a hilltop from which the tin castle of Nick Chopper could plainly be seen, its towers glistening magnificently under the rays of the declining sun. "How pretty!" exclaimed Dorothy. "I've never seen the Emperor's new house before."
"He built it because the old castle was damp and likely to rust his tin body," said Billina. "All those towers and steeples and domes and gables took a lot of tin, as you can see."
"Is it a toy?" asked Button Bright softly.
"No, dear," answered Dorothy. "It's better than that. It's the fairy dwelling of a fairy prince."
End of chapter 14. Chapter 15. The Emperor's Tin Castle. The grounds around Nick Chopper's new house were laid out in pretty flower beds, with fountains of crystal water and statues of tin representing the Emperor's personal friends. Dorothy was astonished and delighted to find a tin statue of herself standing on a tin pedestal at a bend in the avenue leading up to the entrance. It was life-size, and showed her in her sunbonnet with her basket on her arm, just as she had first appeared in the Land of Oz.
"Oh, Toto, you're there, too!" she exclaimed, and sure enough, there was the tin figure of Toto lying at the tin Dorothy's feet. Also, Dorothy saw figures of the Scarecrow and the Wizard and Ozma and many others, including Tik-Tok. They reached the grand tin entrance to the tin castle, and the Tin Woodman himself came running out of the door to embrace little Dorothy and give her a glad welcome. He welcomed her friends as well, and the Rainbow's Daughter he declared to be the loveliest vision his tin eyes had ever beheld. He patted Button Bright's curly head tenderly, for he was fond of children, and turned to the Shaggy Man and shook both his hands at the same time.